for the next speaker, who is Queen Zhijian.
Yes.
So
we wanted to listen last speaker.
I think the last speaker was here, but disappeared from the list.
Alexander, help the last speaker, please.
I see the last speaker is here. Zuan Ti Fion Hui.
No.
Already heard it. The speaker was in the list, but now he isn't.
Yes. Qin Zhijian, he left. Yes. I think. Mm-hmm.
He left the conference, yes.
He left the conference. So it's maybe last presentation today.
But he was a minute ago. Maybe it's technical issue.
Yes, colleague. Is anyone who want to do presentation and we don't listen for him? We wait for Dong. Some minutes, 5 minutes wait. And next.
I want to say that the time appointed was not well, like it was not well balanced because I was not able to get appropriate feedback for my presentation.
Who is speak, please?
Amza.
Okay, Amza. When did you had the presentation during section?
I remember that you have two or three opinions on your presentation.
No.
Irina
was giving me feedback, but she was
Irina
not
first.
The opportunity to.
Yes, Irina first, who give opinion on your presentation. Yuriakrish,
No, I didn't.
It was only Irina that was given. She was in the process, but she was cut off. So I was not able to get
you see, it's maybe such situation. One of referees give you the opinion. It's enough. Maybe
I don't think she finished. She was moving on to other comments, but she was somewhere along the line. She was.
It's very difficult to remember now.
Alexander Markovich, I'm here and I do listen to your comments, and that's what I wanted to.
Okay, please.
I would like to just repeat: your model is not well structured, because as I tried to explain you. Your dependent variable is related to the sales. Your independent variables are also related to the sales, some of them. And that's why it's not an appropriate way to measure the variables, because sales and sales are related.
I get that point. Yeah.
But this is the major point. You need to rethink once again. How you are going to measure your dependent variable, your control variables, and your independent variables. So that's the major point. The topic itself, it's really interesting because we need to understand what you suggested, and you want to say that if we have lower R&D intensity, then maybe we will finally economically prove that this low R&D intensity does not positively affect the business. It's not enough. That's guys, who is talking here? Just switch off, please, your microphones. Thank you. So, that's really an important issue. It's not, of course, I do hope it's not the overall your research question in your dissertation, in the dissertation itself.
No, this one is just intended for publication. It's not dissertation.
Yes, but of course, before you want to submit it to somewhere, to some journal, you need to be very careful with your model. You need to talk to Elena Rogova, who is your supervisor, I guess, and just to try to verify, because if you look at your econometrical data, final data for your model, in one of the regressions, you have unbelievable R squared. When R squared is close to 100%, it says the model is not correct. Because you are going to explain that, yeah, this is just very certain relationship. It's unbelievable in econometrics. So that's, again, the symbol that something is really wrong in the variables. Okay. So the idea is good. Just the idea, the intent, the goal. We need to understand how the level of R&D intensity can affect performance in Nigeria and emerging countries. The second point. Am I right that you just use three companies?
Yes.
But this is very small sample. For econometrical purpose, it's not working.
But I've seen papers, some papers use like selected companies with the intention to understand the selected companies rather than a generalization objective.
Yeah, but in case they are using, as you said, selected companies, which is maybe equivalent to very few companies, then it should mean that maybe those papers are doing case studies, but not econometrical study, because econometrical study with the three companies, even for some years, it's not enough. You cannot generalize from this because you are applying quantitative technique, you are applying some math, you are applying some variables, you are trying to detect some functional relationship. So then okay. If you've got some significant...
You understand?
Generalized saying, oh, from these three companies, we now can make very, really good, significant conclusions. So it will not be published in this case. Maybe you should think in terms of case studies. Talk to your supervisor. If you don't have enough companies in Nigeria, you maybe add some other African countries.
Yeah. Okay, colleague, you understand the comments. Okay, so, colleague, will finish our third and fourth sessions. I might say that don't all presentation will be here. We don't listen presentation from Far East Federal University. We have a lot of question to Artem Potekhin from Novosibirsk and give him some comments and say what he may do next. I think that it's maybe good presentation, but by Renat Dashkin from Kazan Federal University. Here is some questions, we speak about them, but I think it may be a good paper after some work. We don't understand anything from last presentation from State University of Management. Why? Because language, and second, because PhD student don't was in the system. So I must say a lot of thanks to Alexandra Igorova, who helped us to do this PhD workshop at the good level. And maybe Irina Ivashkovskaya say something last words.
Okay, these are last words for the seminar, but not my last words, I guess. So I do think that this year we've got just a plenty of papers of really good quality in terms of PhD workshop criteria, of course. They have a nice publishable potential to be published. That's my first point. The second point, as we already announced, that some of the presentations and some of the presenters can be invited to prepare the text of the papers of the articles to be submitted to our journal, to the journal of our university, which is called Journal of Corporate Finance Research. In few weeks, we are submitting again to Scopus, and we already wait for the answer from Web of Science, because we submitted all the docs many months ago to Web of Science, but the procedure is really too long, and we have to wait. But we will be really happy to consider a few articles from that seminar. In any case, for those who are PhD students in our university, you must know that the journal which is published by our university, the Journal of Corporate Finance Research, is of course eligible for your PhD submission, finally at the final stage, to be defended at before the commission and the committee from the PhD Council. So that's eligible journal, despite it's still not indexed in Scopus, and we are waiting the results. So be prepared to make that decision. Then contact please the journal webpage, and prepare your paper within the criteria of the formatting and making the text and all the references that we require for the purpose of publishing. So we wish to everybody, of course, success, because this is very important period in your lives. You would like to have this additional step in your professional qualification, despite maybe not everybody will be involved then in academic career. But of course, that's very important step to become much smarter, to become much more famous in some academic environment, academic institutions, to get that very nice stamp in your resume for the future steps, especially for those who are going into research, into consultancy, into some advisory. That's really a must to become a person with the PhD qualification. So be very smart in this, be very optimistic, be focused on your topics, and we wish you success. And of course, you should still be very careful with this COVID environment and take care of yourself, please. You are kindly invited to stay in touch with the school finance. In any case, write us and just participate in our workshops and activities, follow our webpage, our announcements, and just be happy. Yuri Yakovlevich, maybe you will also say a few words. Really pleased you joined us, because you are our very nice colleague, and every day and every time when I see you, I would like to say we're really missing you, that you quitted for that Institute of Prorector, Vice Rector Gorberg, but we really need you. And that's the reason that I want to talk to you personally, because I want to make you some additional proposal.
Okay, thank you very much for warm words, Irina Vasilina. So yes, I heard today really interesting papers. A lot of very hot topics were considered. So I think it has some papers about. I remember the risk disclosure was an interesting paper. The another one was about the effect of innovation, sustainability, and financial performance. That was really interesting. Yeah, the paper from Renat from Kazan University also I liked that, and it has a potential, just should be adjusted. But yeah, some really nice interesting ideas and papers. It was nice to listen to these ideas, and I wish all today's presenters good luck, and of course to publish in top-ranked journals, and get finally your so I guess weighted PhDs. So I hope we today at least a little bit helped in achieving this goal. So again, wish you all good luck.
Dear professor, just a couple words. Ioana speaking. Thank you very much for your support, for your feedback. Special thanks to Irina Vasilina for her support for all this time. And hopefully we'll do the best and better for the next months and years of study. Thank you very much.
Best regards for all PhD students.
And I'm also saying very nice words, very sweet words for my colleagues who spend a lot of time today, who spend a few hours and many hours in preparing that workshop, because it takes a lot of effort and energy to structure everything, to go through your abstracts and to make a decision. So many thanks to Alexander Karminsky, who that time looked through all the papers submitted, because I was really overloaded, I could not do it. So that time he was the key person, the single person making the decision, and he was right, because he selected good papers and the good participants. So many thanks to Ella, who joined us even for some sessions during that day. And I do expect that she will not quit high school economics even after the PhD defense. I wish you success in your PhD event in some future, which is upcoming. And of course, many thanks to Alexandra Igorova again and again, because she was very patient running all this technical stuff, which really sometimes is really awful events. And again, many thanks to Yuri Dranev and to my colleagues who already were among the discussions and they left. And still, I would like to write us afterwards if you still have some questions, and just stay in touch. We are trying to be open despite we are really very, very busy these days. So have nice evening, at least Saturday evening.
And best for all.
Nice Sunday. Today I'm having open day for master degree students, so I'm still working on weekend. And that's, of course, it's a type of killing myself, but I need. So thank you for everybody, and I'm saying bye-bye to everybody.
Thank you colleagues. And if you have any questions or maybe some further advice, do not hesitate to contact us. So all our contacts are available at the HSEA website, so we're free to make some other advices.
Okay. Bye-bye.